first thing we're doing is taking one of these decorative coffee signs. I just pulled the kickstand right off and I used a small screwdriver to unscrew the clip. Then we're going to take a nail file and file only the front hole because the back doesn't matter. Be careful not to file the paper off because then you're opening up a floodgate of problems. Now I'm going to take white chalk paint and paint everything but the lid and the sleeve, because I'm going to do something else with them. So I'm just taking chalk paint, going over those areas, leaving the lid and the sleeve alone. I'm going to paint that brown now, the lid, and I'm just going to use that tempera paint, hoping it is able to cover the wording. We'll see what happens. Ah, yes, it does. The craft gods smiled upon us once again. So I'm painting the top brown for the lid. And I was going to do the sleeve brown, but I'm thinking I like that blue. I can't really decide, but I think I might leave it. We'll see how it goes.
Okay. This is what happened to the brown tempera paint when it dried. What? What the hell? Oh my gosh. All right. I guess I will. I don't even know what the hell to do with this. I guess I'm going to, I have no idea what I'm going to do. I guess I'm going to try to rough this up first. Then maybe I will put some chalk paint on it, like as a primer. Hopefully it will adhere better to that. I don't know. Oh my goodness. I don't know what to do with this right now, but I gotta figure something out. Wasn't expecting that to happen.
Now I'm just gonna take one of these foam wreaths and two knit hats from Dollar Tree. These have a fleece lining, so we're gonna end up cutting that out. But you just take your scissors, cut straight up, and then you'll notice that like the four seams on the top that meet, that's going to end up creating a problem, which I'll show you. So we'll have to cut that off as well. And we're going to have to separate the fleece lining as well. So that's the seam and that's not going to work, you see. So we have to cut right below that seam and get that out of there. So just cut that part off. Throw it right in the garbage. We don't need it. And now you're just going to separate and cut out the fleece lining as well, because we don't need that. That'll be nothing but problems. And once you do that, you're going to have a nice square of this little knit fabric. So we're just going to be wrapping it around the wreath. And this project takes a lot of hot glue, but we're just going to be wrapping it around and hot gluing it around the wreath, obviously making sure to put your seam on the back side of the wreath. That will not show. Yeah. Knit material and hot glue. Make sure you put your little finger protectors on. Okay, as we were. So you're just going to go ahead, pull that nice and tight using tons of hot glue on this wreath. So you just fold it over, tuck it all in, glue it again. And that's your first piece. So now we cut again, same way we did the first time, and just continue doing that until the entire wreath is covered. So this is what the finished product looks like. Now you will end up having multiple seams, but we are going to be gluing some things to this wreath, so we will cover at least two of these seams with things. So we'll just pick the ugliest seams to cover and it'll be totally fine. So I have this paint pen and I'm just writing sweater weather. I forgot to tell you, I did in fact sand the brown with a nail file and then repaint it, and it did stay. Now I think I'm just going to go in and put a line with permanent marker just to make it look like the top of the sippy cup. So I'm just going to go ahead and do that here. Just a simple line to give it some dimension for the sippy part. I have to fix that because the paint came off. Don't worry about that. All right, then I have these Jolie Boutique knit flower stickers. So they are knit like sweater material, which is awesome, and they're perfect for this wreath. So I'm just taking them out of the package. They are zip tied in there, and it's a double layer package, and it's a pain in the butt. But once we get them all out, we're just going to decide where to position them. I'm trying to decide if I want all four together. I have four of them. If I want all four together, and I'm picking one of my seams, I am imagining my coffee cup as well over one of the seams. And I'm thinking I'm going to keep it like that. So I'm going to keep them separated. Just want to make sure. And I think I like the way that looks. So I'm just going to go ahead and glue them again. Ton of hot glue. So I'm going to do two in one spot, two in another spot. That's just my preference. Remember, all of my DIYs are for inspiration only. I want you to take them and go run with the idea and make it your own. All right, so we glue them on. Again, being very generous with the hot glue. Should have had the finger protectors on for that too. So that is... those are the flowers. And now for the coffee cup, I am just going to basically unload almost an entire glue stick on here. I'm just kidding, but a lot. All right. So we just do that. Glue it on. So here's the finished product hanging. I decided to paint a wooden maple leaf in the silver paint pen and attach it there. I also need to finish that line on top of the coffee once another layer of paint dries that I had to touch up. And I made a little hanger out of another piece of the hat as well to hang it with. But I love it. I think it's super cute and I'm happy with it. So I hope you guys all enjoyed. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment, and I'll see you all very soon. Until the next video, stay blessed, my friends.